bless the Lord, beloved. We're so excited to have you join us once again for another wonderful week on the Voice of Resurrection Devotional. This week, we're devoting our entire time to the good ground, the good soil, where the Word of God is sown and there is fruit at different levels, but yet there is fruit, beloved, whether at the 10% level, the 30%, the 60%, or 100-fold, it doesn't matter. That's our mandate this week, that you desire, I desire, to be a fruitful ground. It doesn't matter my present condition. It doesn't matter what I'm going through. May God help me produce fruit. Hallelujah. May God help you produce fruit in Jesus' name. Beloved, it's in my spirit, even before I get to my text, many times you desire to produce fruit after you come through what you're going through. You plan to start ministering. You plan to start helping. You postpone your divine opportunities. This is the word of the Lord unto you today. God is calling you to produce fruit today. As you step out of that door this morning, doesn't matter, even if you have a headache, even if you just had a fight at home, no matter what's going on, even if you're on trial on your job and they're threatening to fire you, may the mandate of God come upon you now. May you sense your call. You're on a mission. You're a man on a mission. Somebody will get saved today through you. Somebody will receive prayer for a miracle today. Somebody will be touched by God through you in Jesus' name. Beloved, that's a word from the throne. I feel the joy of the Lord bubbling in my spirit for you and for me, for a divine connection today in Jesus' name. Amen. Come on, celebrate before you walk out the door. Glory to God. Let me read our text for today, Mark chapter 4, verse 20. The Bible says, "And these are they which are sown on good ground." I don't know about you, I'm claiming it today. I am good ground. I am good soil. I am a great deposit for God to sow into, for people to sow into. Because when I'm sown into, I will produce fruit for God and for His kingdom. Claim the same, beloved. Don't wait till you get everything perfect. No, you can be fruitful now in Jesus' name. Amen. "And these are they which are sown on good ground, such as hear the word," you're hearing the word now, "and receive it." Don't fight the word, receive it. I'm going to show you these keys. Number 3, "and bring forth fruit, some 30-fold, some 60, and some 100-fold. Hey, beloved, let me say it again. Whether you are the 30 or 60 or 100, it doesn't matter, beloved. Just produce fruit. That's all that counts. Amen. Amen. I want to read the same text in Luke chapter 8, verse 15, because that is where we will be concentrating. The Bible says, "But that on the good ground are they which in an honest and good heart, having heard the word, keep it and bring forth fruit with patience." Wow. When you put them all together, beloved, the text becomes loaded. And we'll see didactically God's steps for you and I to produce fruit that we can follow tangibly and experience or manifest the same result. What does Mark say? First, the key to producing fruit is to hear the word of God. Because many times, beloved, we have ears, but we don't hear. Stubbornness, anger, bitterness, judgments block us. We can't hear. That happens to people. They sit in church. Once they make a judgment, no matter what you preach, they cannot hear. Beloved, you hear the word. Your ears are still open. Number two, you receive the word. Hallelujah. No excuses. The word is for you. The word is for me. Because without the word, you cannot produce fruit. Except the word of God conceives in your spirit, you will produce zero fruit. May God help us and deliver us. The good ground, then, is a ground with a hearing ear. It's a ground with a seeing eye. It's a ground with a willing heart. Hallelujah. He says, they which in an honest and good heart, having heard the word, keep it and bring forth fruit with patience. We will get deeper, beloved, to learn what the Spirit is saying to us, so that this glory on this broadcast will motivate you to go out and start doing something for the kingdom every day. In Jesus' name. Remember, you're a man on a mission. As you step out that door, may your miracles collide with your path. In Jesus' name. Amen. We'll see you tomorrow. We love you. Bye-bye.
The Lord is waiting on you.
Yes, he is. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. Yes, he is.